About Santa, Part 8. The flatlining heart monitor gives way to beep, 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 beep. The incessant, piercingly loud blaring of a smoke detector fills the air, demanding attention. Now, out of the blackness, we are in Emilia's living room. Beep, 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 beep. Smoke floats in from the kitchen. Emilia enters, running with such panic and determination she does not notice the roll of wrapping paper taped to her hand unfurling behind her.
Fruitcake! Oh.
She looks down at her hand and sees the wrapping paper. Pulling it off, she rolls the paper back up as she calmly walks to the smoke detector.
Hush.
She turns off the alarm and strolls to the kitchen.
Never did like fruitcake.
And she's gone. The smoke dissipates. The room is silent, but not for long. Knocking to the tune of Pop Goes the Weasel is heard. Then, a doorbell. Emilia walks back into the living room, wearing oven mitts and carrying the charred fruitcake.
Come on in!
Ben and Asher come through the door, bustling with Christmas cheer. Asher has a black eye.
Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, Christmas.
Ding dong, it's Christmas time.
Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong, Christmas. Take it, Emilia!
He holds an invisible microphone to Amelia's mouth. She smiles.
Ding dong, the 4th of July!
Rock and roll! You've been practicing.
Ah, just natural talent. I regret to inform you that there will be no fruitcake this year.
You did the Lord's work. I'm sorry we're late. You know my parents, they're yappers. They yap. Yap into the wee hours.
They have an impressive yap game.
Unbeatable.
Asher, what's up with the eye, Mr. Magoo?
She takes Asher's hand and sits him on the couch, examining his face.
Does it hurt? What happened?
I was hoping you wouldn't see.
Did you think I wouldn't see that?
Do you want to tell her, buddy, or do you want me?
Asher hangs his head. He's embarrassed.
I got into a fight.
On the bus, last day before break. Took an elbow to the face.
Fight? Why?
Asher looks to Ben for guidance.
We're gonna have to talk about that.
Am I in trouble?
Emilia gives him a playful noogie.
No. You can't get into fights. You okay?
I'm great! Check it out!
He pulls out a brightly colored electronic toy from his backpack.
Grandma and Grandpa got me a Diatachi for Christmas!
A Diatachi! That's so...
Ben motions her over to the other side of the room.
I know. I told them that was the Santa present. They got it anyway.
Okay. Well, we can make it work. Mom's house Diatachi and Dad's house Diatachi.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
It's fine. We'll just have to figure out how to work the Santa angle.
Look, maybe it's time to tell them the truth. The fight, Emilia, the fight was about Santa.
Let me guess. A bunch of kids were saying, we don't believe in Santa, we believe in our parents.
Yeah, exactly. How did you know?
Maternal intuition. You're right. We should tell him. It's just that when I was a kid, my mom...
A cell phone on the coffee table starts to vibrate. Emilia picks it up and looks at it and laughs.
It's just my mom has impeccable timing. Hi, Mom. Very Merry Christmas to you, too. I did. I burnt the fruitcake in effigy. Asher's great. Really excited about Santa coming tonight. We have not. Ben's here. He's staying for dinner.
I am.
Emilia covers the receiver.
It's Christmas Eve. What else are you going to do?
Eat Fritos and watch Die Hard?
Staying for dinner. I guess you can. Don't you want to talk to Asher? She wants to talk to you.
Ben's eyes widen. He tries to wave her off.
One of the great joys of divorce is that you don't have to talk to the mother-in-law anymore.
Please. You take this, and I'll handle the you-know-what.
Ben looks to Asher, then back to Emilia.
Deal.
He takes the phone. Emilia mouths thank you, Ben starts walking out of the room as he talks.
Hi, Diane. No, we haven't had that talk. I don't know, but I think Emilia was about to...
He exits. Emilia sits on the couch next to Asher.
So, Asher, sweetie, about Santa Claus.
Asher puts his hand on her mouth.
Don't say it.
Don't say what?
Don't say there's no Santa.
I say there's no Santa.
No. So there is a Santa?
Well, that's complicated.
Why?
Why is it complicated? That's complicated too.
Everything's complicated.
Yes, but what I'm trying to say is the truth about Santa.
Bum bum! Emilia and Asher both look up to the ceiling. A familiar sound from above. Bubum, 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 bubum.
I know him. He's a nice guy.
He is? You do?
Surprised.
No. I always knew it was true.
A pair of black boots plop down in the fireplace. They are attached to a chubby body and a white whiskered covered face. Santa enters, ducking in from the hearth.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, Emilia! Ha! And this must be young Asher.
You know who I am?
Of course! Your name features prominently on Santa's nice list, just like your mother's.
He was on the nice list? The N-I-C-E list?
Santa gives a solemn nod.
He was. Years after you, of course.
Did you bring me anything?
Asher, don't be rude.
Rude nonsense. I'm Santa. Bringing things is my job.
He reaches into his sack and pulls out a Diatachi.
Now I understand you already have one of these, but this one was made by my elves with great care. Not another one like it.
Thanks.
Now let's see. I have some batteries here somewhere.
He fumbles in his pockets and finds some batteries.
Let's see. Here we are.
He kneels down to Asher and the two start fiddling with the toy. Ben enters.
Yikes. That was indeed rough.
I owe you.
Ben notices Asher and Santa on the couch.
So, I see you've preserved Asher's childhood for another year. Have a good talk.
Don't. Just give me one more Christmas.
Sorry. Eggnog?
Sure.
Rum?
No thanks.
You got it.
Ben exits to the kitchen. Santa stands, watching him leave.
It was certainly a pleasure meeting you, young man.
I'm going to tell everybody at school I met you.
Please do. Please spread the good word.
He takes out a pocket watch, opens it.
Oh, dear. Emilia, the time is, as they say, nigh.
Emilia stares at Asher.
What about my upgrade?
It won't stop the deletion.
Asher, sweetie, I'm going to go to the North Pole with Santa for a little while.
Really? Can I come?
I'm afraid not. It's a matter of international law, you know.
It will only be a little bit.
Santa starts to get into the fireplace. Emilia starts to duck in with him, then stops.
Just one more minute.
The deletion sweep is about to start.
Do I have one more minute?
Santa looks at his watch.
You do, maybe less. I'll have to migrate on to the new server with or without you. Meet me on the rooftop. Come up with a wink of your eye and a twist of your head.
You have nothing to dread.
Santa likes it when you rhyme.
And with a wink of his eye and a twist of his head, he disappears up the fireplace. Emilia takes a book off the mantel.
Why don't we read 'Twas the Night Before Christmas?
She sits back down next to Asher and opens up the book.
I know you just met Santa, so this might seem like old hat now, but it's tradition. Can't break tradition.
I was worried you forgot.
Emilia kisses his head.
I'd never forget.
She opens the book, starts reading.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house.
Boom.
Merry Christmas to all! And you all a good time!
Off to the North Pole he goes.
You're not going with him?
Emilia smiles, putting her arm around Asher, pulling him closer.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even...
A flash of blinding white light, then blackness. The end.